wholesome golden girl. You better shape up, 'cause I need a man. Turned leather, then spandex-clad American starlet. The music and movie that made Dame Olivia Newton John a Hollywood star. Today, fans and old friends gathered in Tinseltown to remember her.
It hits hard, you know, when your idols die. It's just like even a piece of your family, too, because you grew up with them.
Well, I'm doing the best I can to not do this. No, she was incredible. She was just as lovely on the inside as she was on the outside.
Dame Olivia's singing career started as a teenager, but it wasn't until Eurovision, singing for her birth country Britain, that she hit the spotlight. As an American career in country music blossomed, Newton John nearly turned down the opportunity that would make her a household name.
She insisted on having a screen test before she agreed to do this. She wanted to make sure that everybody, including herself, felt like she could pull this off, and she did with flying colors.
The movie Grease and its best-selling soundtrack went on to make her an overnight sensation. Hopelessly. There was even a riot at the premiere. And it led to lifelong friendships with her co-stars. John Travolta paying tribute today to his dearest Olivia. I love you so much. We will see you down the road and we will all be together again. You're Danny, you're John, he wrote. Newton John went on to win 4 Grammys and sold 100 million records. As her career cooled in later years, Newton John took on another role, cancer survivor and fundraiser. Despite her breast cancer returning and spreading, she still performed, releasing new music right up until last year.
It's been a wonderful ride.
A ride so many of us have been privileged to share.
Come on, Sandy!
Goodbye!
Dame Olivia was one of Australia's most beloved treasures. Tributes flowing from across the country, from political leaders to Kylie Minogue. But as Australia correspondent Andrew McFarlane reports, she wanted to be remembered for more than music and movies.
Olivia Newton-John's been a near lifelong darling of Australia.
Australia's sweetheart is receiving the nation's highest honour.
The greaser becoming a dame in a country she'd moved to when she was just 6. From first appearing on screens in the 60s to the Sydney Olympics, even the ARIA Hall of Fame.
And I realised that it was Australia and her people that has shaped most of my life.
In true form, the Aussies had claimed her as one of their own.
She was iconic.
She's an Australian icon.
She's an Australian icon.
From one pop princess to another, Kylie Minogue, who's also fought breast cancer, saying she was, and always will be, an inspiration in so many, many ways. But despite defining a generation with her movies and music, Dame Olivia wanted her cancer charity work to be her lasting legacy.
Is it difficult for you to do that?
Afterwards.
Share it with them.
I've been there, so I understand the fear.
Her family asking for tributes to be donations to the Olivia Newton-John Cancer Wellness Centre.
She was so proud of the work that she's done with us here.
And in New Zealand too, attending the launch of the Breast Cancer Foundation in 1994. And even as her own cancer returned, she remained positive.
My hospital raised lots of money so that we can make cancer a thing of the past, and I'm sure this is part of my journey. This is part of the reason I really believe that it happened, so that I could experience it yet again and give me more impetus to do more about it.
Dame Olivia was never the victim, only a fighter. Andrew McFarlane, One News, Sydney.